Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video where the questions that we are going to discuss are of use for you if you are appearing for RBI, SEBI, NABARD examinations. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you have not subscribed our channel till now, then do subscribe and hit this bell notification because this is going to help you in staying connected with our channel. This is the Telegram group which you can join if you want to enjoy the quizzes that we provide as well as you want to get the latest updates on our channel regarding the examinations. And the link of this Telegram channel is in description below. So you can join it from that link. So this is the first question that we are going to discuss. Which country has inaugurated world's largest floating solar panel farms? Vietnam, Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore and Philippines. So these are the five options out of which Singapore is the right answer. So guys, do you know what is the capacity of this panel farm? It is 60 megawatts. So what will happen if I say that India has already developed a floating solar power plant that has a capacity of 600 megawatts? Then you would be amazed, right? That if India has developed it, then why Singapore is claiming to develop such the largest solar power plant in the world? So the answer is that the Omkareshwar power project, okay, solar, basically this is Omkareshwar Dam solar, floating solar power project of 600 megawatt capacity is basically under development. It is under construction. So by the year 2022 to 2023, it will start providing electricity. So it will start operating by the year 2022 to 2023. So absolutely that this largest floating solar panel farm that Singapore has developed is not the largest in the world at present, because Omkareshwar has already been developed by India, which has 10 times more power generation capacity than the one that Singapore has developed. But if you are asked that which country has developed the world's largest solar power panel plant or the farms which is operational at present, then Singapore would be the right answer. But in general, if the question is asked, then this Omkareshwar solar power project is the right answer. Now guys, do you know on which river is this power plant being developed? Because remember this word floating. So this is the floating power plant. So basically it is built on a river and it constantly floats. So it is built on a, I would say on a platform which is on the river. So it constantly floats. So on which river is this Omkareshwar project has been developed? The right answer is Narmada River in Madhya Pradesh. So guys, remember these facts that India has developed this Omkareshwar Dam, which has 600 megawatt of capacity, but still it is not operational yet. It is going to become operational by 2022 to 2023. Now South Korea is planning to do a magnanimous thing, I would say more one or two steps ahead of India, because South Korea is planning to develop a solar power plant which is of 2.1 gigawatt of capacity. So obviously this is almost two, three steps ahead of India, because the capacity is very huge, power generation capacity. So it is planning to develop this floating solar power plant, but still it is in the planning stage only. So South Korea has only proposed to develop this solar power plant. So if you search it on the Google and you see this name, sorry for the typing error, if you see this name signing up as the world's largest floating solar power plant, then don't be mistaken, because this is the proposed plant that is of 2.1 gigawatt capacity and it is still in the proposal stage. It is going to be developed by South Korea. Okay, so that is all about the solar power plants that are being developed. Okay, so before moving ahead, I would like to ask a question from you guys, and that question is that all these countries have one commonality among them, and that is they all are the members of ASEAN. Can you tell me the names of remaining members of ASEAN? So this is your task. Please tell me in the comment section below how many members are there, which are left, okay, in Asia. Next is, which state has established India's first pod taxi? So pod taxi is basically a small pod wherein the people sit, and it is a driverless taxi. So it operates on the cables that are run by electricity. So it is completely electric, eco-friendly, driverless pod taxi, and also it is going to be work, or it runs on the bridges that are laid over the roads. So it is definitely going to help in reducing congestion on the roads. So that is the benefit for which pod taxi has been developed. But which state has developed it? We haven't discussed that yet. So the right answer here is Uttar Pradesh. From Noida Airport, Noida International Airport, to Noida Film City. So right now it is going to cover this short distance only, but let's see if this plan is spread across the state, then it is going to be a revolutionary plan in the road traffic, in the road transportation, particularly for the daily passengers, because this is going to save a lot of time for the daily passengers. If this becomes useful or if it becomes commercialized like we have Delhi metros, only then this is going to be a benefit for the passengers. So this is the distance that is being covered through this pod taxi. Now, this international airport has been developed in partnership with this Zurich International AG. So this company has partnered with the Uttar Pradesh government to develop this Noida International Airport. So that was all about this question. I hope that you have understood it well. Now let's move on to the next question. What is the name of the campaign launched by the Indian Council for Cultural Relations to give a platform to the traditional folk artists, local artists and or artisans for performance? So, Kala Manch, Kala Pradarshini, Kala Pragati, Kala Vishw, Kala Protsahan. Which one is the right answer, guys? The right answer is option D. Kala Vishw is the name of the portal that has been launched by ICCR to promote the art, first of all, and to give a platform to the folk artists so that they can perform on, basically, so they can perform. So this is a campaign under which traditional folk art will be promoted. Here, two things are important that you need to remember. First is that this ICCR has launched this campaign from its Mumbai center. Now, why is this important? You will get to know it when you know the second fact that you need to remember from this news. The second fact here is that this campaign focuses on the folk arts of Maharashtra and Goa. So it is at present, it is the present scenario wherein this campaign is focusing on the traditional folk arts of Maharashtra and Goa. So that was all about this Kala Vishw campaign. I hope that you have understood it well. Now guys, this ICCR, its headquarters is in New Delhi. Can you guys tell me who is the president of this organization? Because this is a very important arm of Ministry of External Affairs. It boosts or it takes care of the operations in the field of culture. So it boosts and strengthens India's cultural ties with other countries as well. Okay, so that is why this organization is important. New Delhi is the headquarter. You have to tell me who is the president of this organization. Which state has launched ASAP startup promotion scheme? So Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Gujarat and Andhra Pradesh are in the options. Andhra Pradesh is the right answer. So ASAP stands for Accelerator Startup in Andhra Pradesh. So this is the scheme that has been launched, and very obviously it is going to promote these startups. Now, what kind of startups and what kind of services will be provided to the startups under this scheme? So basically, the first thing about the scheme that you need to know is that it is going to target the early stage startups that have not achieved much in their businesses till now, and that those startups need investment, the startups need mentorship. Only those startups will be targeted through this scheme. The second point here that you need to understand is that under the scheme, plug and play office services, office space basically, incubation or support at center of excellences, and also the link to investors. So these kinds of services will be provided to these startups. So what is the meaning of each of these things? Plug and play office space is the ready to use office space. All these softwares and all the things will be ready to use, and such kind of office spaces will be provided to the startups that will enroll or become eligible under this scheme. Okay? Of course, they will not be provided for free to the startups. They will have to pay, but a minimal charge or in exchange of some kind of fee. Okay? Next is incubation support. So incubation support is all for which the scheme has been launched. Next is investors. So many of these startups face this huge problem of funding. Majority of these startups do not find right investors, or the investors are not interested in investing in the businesses. Although the prospects are high that the business concept will fulfill or will become prosperity, but still they face some kind of investor problem. Therefore, in order to resolve that problem, investors, linkage to the investors. So basically, this under this program, the government or the functionaries will provide a link to these startups so that they can connect with the investors. That is the investment support that will be provided to these startups under the scheme. The third point here is that which kind of startups are allowed to become beneficiaries under this scheme. So these startups that are in the field of information technology, emerging technologies like machine learning, Internet of Things, then you have information technology and all kinds of technology related fields, emerging technology related fields like artificial intelligence. So all these kinds of startups, the startups that are working in these fields will become eligible for benefit under this scheme. Take it clear? I hope that this much is clear to you. The next point here is that a fund of fund will be created by the government itself under this scheme, and the fund will be of 100 crore. Now, what is this fund of funds? Majority of you should know what this fund of funds is. If you are an aspirant of RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any kind of banking examinations, because this is a very common term, guys, that a banking aspirant should be aware of. So a fund of fund is basically a mutual fund that invests in other mutual funds. That is the term for fund of funds. So this kind of fund of fund will be created, which will be of 100 crore to fund these startups. So government will also provide funding to some startups that will not be able to gather funding from the investors. So that is the another point. The next point here is that this ASAP startup promotion scheme was already announced in the IT promotion policy of Andhra Pradesh for the year 2021 to 2024. So this policy was launched last month only in June 2021, wherein Andhra Pradesh envisaged to make Visakhapatnam the IT hub. Visakhapatnam, Kakinanda, Tirupati, Vijayawada and Anantapuram. So these are the five places that will be developed as mega IT hub. Okay, wherein the focus will be on Visakhapatnam, because in Visakhapatnam only the IT technologies research university will also be developed by the state. Apart from this, integrated technology parks will also be developed in the state. in Visakhapatnam particularly. So these two things will be developed in Visakhapatnam only, because Visakhapatnam is in the focus in this IT policy 2021 to 2024. So that policy is very important from your exam point of view. First of all, it is very latest. Secondly, it is focusing on the IT hub in the, or we can say on the emerging technologies. If you know that the neighboring state of this Andhra Pradesh only announced technology year, the year of AI. Can you tell me which year is declared as the year of artificial intelligence by Telangana? So this is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section below. So next question is, which has become the first airline in the Middle East to join the IATA Turbulence Aware platform? So IATA stands for International Air Transport Association. Middle East Airlines, Fly Dubai, Saudi Arabian Airlines, Etihad Airlines, Airways or Qatar Airways? Right answer is Qatar Airways. So what is this IATA Turbulence Aware platform? So first of all, you need to know that this platform was launched in 2018. And basic purpose is to collect the information, the data related to turbulence, because the turbulence in during the travel of the aircraft, okay, the turbulence that is created or that is faced by the airlines during their travel causes a lot of harm to the crew, passengers, as well as the plane itself. So in order to reduce that turbulence is basically the problem faced by the aircrafts during their flight, during their travel, or at the time of landing, or at the time of taking off. So all kind of turbulence that they face, that is reported, and the data is provided to each and every aircraft and the pilot so that they can avoid such kind of events from happening again. So that is the purpose of this IATA Turbulence Aware platform, which has been joined by this Qatar Airways right now, and it became the first one from the Middle East to join this platform. So now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following film has won the Palme d'Or? Basically, this is the Golden Palm Award at the Cannes Film Festival 2021. This is an annual film festival that is held at Cannes in France. So it is of indigenous, we can say, or the domestic film festival of France. Now, which movie has won this award? So you have the five movies right in front of you, and the right answer is Titan. So this movie has won this award. Guys, because this is a domestic film festival, therefore it is not very important for us. Only the best film, the film that has got the best award in this film festival is important. Now, who directed this movie? It is Julia Ducournau. So she directed this movie, and this movie has got this prize. Basically, this award has been given to Julia Ducournau for this movie. So that is the difference. Guys, these awards are not very important. I'm again repeating myself, because only the most important movie, the most highlighted movie is this only. So you can remember this much only from this news. Now, if you remember that this year in 2021, Nomadland has got the Oscars. Can you tell me who directed that movie? Who is the director of that movie? Because the person was very much in the news, I would say, for controversial reasons, because more than being in the news for winning the Oscar, she was in the news because of controversial reasons. So let me tell you that she's a Chinese and she was banned from China. I mean, her award was not recognized in China. Now you have to tell me that who is that person? What is the name of that person in the comment section below? So that's all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. And if you have, then do not forget to subscribe and like the video. Thank you so much.